was a goblin in the woods over here. He just flew down in the field. He can see my decoy, but the way he's acting, he's got company or something, because he won't come off that ridge. He's just out of shotgun range, but it's early, so who knows what'll happen here.
At the turn of the century, the wild turkey was nearly extinct. They were hunted to the point of almost vanishing. Luckily, we have learned from our mistakes. And now the wild turkey is thriving throughout North America. Hunters have given millions of dollars towards the conservation of the wild turkey, and now we can hunt them in nearly every state. It's a testament to conservation and our love of wild things.
Uh-oh. We got a jake coming in the field now. This could get interesting. I've seen this jake before. That big Tom's always whooping on him, so I don't know what's gonna happen here, but he's puffed up like he's gonna challenge the big Tom today. He's hanging out over there, kinda like white trash. He's white trailer trash.
I'm Tim Wells, the Slock Master, and I use Morel Targets, Carbon Express Arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use cold steel knives. I light them up with Luminox and wear mossy oak camo. I kill animals with Grim Reapers. I use Muzzy for big fish and put their meat in Canyon coolers. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call. And I drive a Ford truck, because Ford trucks are tough. I killed my first turkey when I was 21 years old, with my father in Deer Ridge, Missouri. And I remember taking my first gobbler. It was a day I will forever be grateful for. But it wasn't till I was 40 years old that I could hunt them in Illinois. Now there are many. And as long as we work together as hunters and conservationists, there always will be.
Maybe I can coax him over to my decoy. Sometimes if you can coax a jake up to your decoy, the Tom will come in. But I don't. It doesn't hurt to try.
Thank you.
the Jake suddenly realizes that he's the only boss in town.
Jake's got her all to himself now. Big Louie's dead. It's his lucky day.
I figured I'd just sit back and watch the show. He was so happy he could hardly contain himself. He tried to get the girls to dance, but they weren't having it. So he came over and did the two-step with my decoy. She was a lousy dancer, so he slapped her around a little bit. He finally had enough. And that was it.
$5 is $5. You gotta appreciate beautiful things like that, man. That Jake fooled him. Sometimes if you get a Jake out in the field and you can coax him up to your decoy, if you got a stubborn old Tom, he'll come on in. We took out Big Tom and Jake was happy, and then he tried to get with the girls and the girls didn't want none of that, so he came over and he got my decoy. So good for him. He's happy, I'm happy. It's just a happy day. Happy, happy.
Just parked the truck and was getting ready to go turkey hunting up the ridge here, and I noticed something that a lot of people have never seen, but this is actually a rabbit's nest, and the babies are gone. They've either been discovered by a coyote or they've already took off. They don't stay in the nest too long after they're born, just maybe a week or two probably. But look here, they take and they actually burrow a little hole down in the ground. They've got a little hole in the ground about the size of your fist, and that's where she'll drop her babies in there. And then look at all the hair that the rabbit has pulled out of its body to insulate the hole, and then she covers them up. And then she won't stay on them like a bird would. She just covers them up and they stay there, and then she comes in and gives them their milk and then gets away real quick so she doesn't leave all that scent. And that's how they raise the baby rabbits. And the rabbits aren't as thick as they used to be in the Midwest because of one reason, and that's the coyote. So it's important to hunt the coyote and keep a strong balance with predator populations, and that's what we're going to do now.
Was a close shot, about 15 yards right in front of me. He came hobbling around that corner, came right in my slock zone right there. I was gonna shoot him when he first came around the corner, but he was acting so stupid. I was like, I'm gonna let him come all the way right up against me. He got in here close enough I could smell his breath. Nailed him. Let's go see if we can find that coyote.